Hi children, good morning. I hope you are safe at home. Today, let us discuss the Dear Departed play written by William Stanley Upton. In this play, the author criticizes the degradation of the human values in the British community. And in this play, we know there are seven characters: Mrs. Emilia Slater, Mrs. Elizabeth Jordan, Henry Slater, Ben Jordan, Victoria Slater, the daughter of Emilia Slater, and Mr. Abel Meriwether, the father of Emilia Slater and Elizabeth Jordan, and Jimmy, the son of Elizabeth Jordan. When Mrs. Slater and her husband found that Mr. Abel Meriwether died in his room, then they sent a telegram to her sister. And according to the situation, they all wore a black dress. And this is called a mourning dress according to the situation. Then Mrs. Jordan came and they wanted to share the things between them. So they wanted to bring the bureau and they brought it. And Mrs. Slater asked her daughter to go to Mr. Abel Meriwether room and bring the bunch of keys. And this little girl gets frightened to go to her grandfather's room. And reluctantly, she goes to the room and brings the bunch of keys. And she found her grandfather getting up. Then she came and told, "Mom, Grandpa is getting up." And when Mr. Abel Meriwether came down from his room, then they were all shocked. And when he came to the hall and said, then he saw both his daughters with their husbands. Then Mr. Abel Meriwether asked, "What's the matter with little Vicky?" Then Mr. Abel Meriwether sees Ben and Mrs. Jordan. Then he greets them, "Hello, what brings you here? And how yourself, Ben?" Then, as usual, he wants to greet. Then Mr. Abel Meriwether thrust his hand at Ben, and Ben smartly skips back and retreats to Mrs. Jordan to a safe distance below the sofa, because they could not believe that he was alive. Till then they thought Mr. Abel Meriwether died. Now as soon as they saw Mr. Abel Meriwether, they were all shocked. Then Mrs. Slater also was shocked, and she approached her father carefully and said, "Father, is that you?" Then she pokes him with her hand to see if he is solid. Then Abel said, "Of course, it's me. Don't do that, Emilia. And what the devil do you mean by this tomfoolery?" When Mrs. Slater pokes her father with her hand to see if he is solid or if what she sees is real, then Mr. Abel Meriwether said, "Of course, it's me. But don't do that, or don't pinch it, or don't poke me with your hand, because it pains me." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "You took us by surprise, Father. Are you keeping quite well?" Then Mrs. Jordan said, "Father, you surprised us. Are you keeping quite well?" Then Abel, trying to catch the words, and said, "Yeah, what?" Then Mrs. Jordan said again, "Are you quite well?" Then Abel said, "Yeah, I am right enough, but for a bit of headache." Then he looked at Emilia and asked Emilia, "What the dickens did I do with my new slippers?" Then he was searching for his slippers. When Mr. Abel Merriweather came down from his room, he wore socks but not shoes. Only came down with his socks, and now he wanted to wear his new pair of slippers, and then he was searching for his slippers. Then when Miss Abel Merriweather asked about his slippers, then she was confused. Then Mrs. Slater said, "Aren't they by the earth, father?" Then Mr. Abel said, "I don't see them." Just then, Miss Abel Merriweather observed Henry trying to remove the slippers. Why? Because Mrs. Latter gave the new slippers of her father to her husband, Henry. And even though the slippers were too small, but Henry wore the slippers of her father. Then Miss Abel Merriweather said, "Why have you got them on, Henry?" Then immediately Mrs. Slater promptly said, "I told him to put them on to stretch them because they were that new and hard." "No, Henry." Then Victoria said, "Oh, Grandpa, I'm so glad that you are not dead." Then Mrs. Slater told her daughter, "Shh, hold your tongue, Victoria." Then Abel said, "Yeah, what's that? Who has gone dead?" Then Mrs. Slater said loudly, "Victoria says she's sorry for your head." So Mrs. Slater said this was because Mr. Abel Merriweather said he had headache. So in order to cover the matter, she said, "Victoria says she is sorry for your head." Then Abel said, "Oh, thank you, Vicky, but I am feeling better now." Usually in our community, or in any community, small children like the grandfather and the grandparents. Understand? So small children like grandparents. Now, Victoria liked her grandfather. Then again, Abel said, "Why, Ben, you are in mourning, and Lizzie too, and Emilia and Henry and little Vicky. Who has gone dead? And is someone in the family?" Then he laughs. Then when Mr. Abel Merriweather saw all the people, both his daughters and his sons-in-law and Miss and Victoria also wearing a mourning dress. Mourning dress means a black dress. Usually in the European community or in foreign countries, people wear black dress when someone died in the family. To express the sorrow and grief, they wear black dress to express their sadness. When Mr. Abel Merriweather found his two daughters and his granddaughter and his sons-in-law in black dress, he was surprised and asked, "Why, Ben, you are in mourning, and Lizzie," Lizzie means Elizabeth, "and Emilia and Henry and little Vicky, who has gone dead? Is someone in the family?" Then he laughs. Then Mrs. Slater said, "No one you know, father, a relation of Ben's." Now, Mrs. Slater don't want to say the truth. Then she said, "A relation of Ben's has died." Then Abel said, "And what relation of Ben's?" The Slater said, his brother. Then Ben said to Slater, damn it, I never had one. Then Ben got irritated and said, I never got a brother. I never had a brother. Then Abel said, dear, dear, and what was his name, Ben? Then Ben was confused. Then he did not know what to say. Then he moves from his place from the table. Then Mr. Slater said, Frederick. So then Mrs. Jordan said, Albert. Then Ben said, Fred, Alp, Isaac. Because when all these three people give different names like Frederick, Albert, Isaac, and so on, then Ben was confused. Yeah, Mr. Abel Meriwether was confused. Then Ben said, then Ben did not know what to say. Then he said, Fred, Alp, Isaac. Fred means Frederick, Al means Albert, Ice means Isaac. So they don't want to tell the truth. Then Abel said, Isaac, and where did your brother Isaac die? Then Ben said, in Australia. So they were not sure what to say. So they were trying to give one name. Then Abel said, rising, well, I suppose you have only been waiting for me to begin tea. I'm feeling hungry. Then Mrs. Slater, taking up the kettle and said, I will make tea. Then Abel said, come along now. Sit you down and let's be jolly. Now when Mr. Abel Meriwether saw his two daughters and two sons-in-law, then he was very happy. Then he said, come along now, sit you down and let's be jolly. Now here we can see Mr. Abel Meriwether and Mrs. Slater, Ben Jordan, Henry, and Emilia Slater and Victoria. So now they are trying to have tea. Then Abel suddenly remembered, said, hey, Emilia and Henry, what the devil did you mean by shipping my bureau out of my bedroom? When he saw his bureau in the hall, he was surprised and shocked and asked about his bureau. Then when Mr. Abel Meriwether spoke about the bureau, Mr. Henry and Mrs. Slater were speechless. Then again he said, do you hear me, Henry and Emilia? Then Mr. Jordan said, what bureau was that, father? Then Abel said, why, my bureau, the one I bought. Here, Mr. Jordan doesn't know about the bureau. See, when Mr. Abel Meriwether bought the bureau, Mrs. Jordan was not there. So she was not aware of the bureau that belonged to her father. Then Abel said, why, my bureau, the one I bought. Then Mrs. Jordan, pointing at the bureau and asked, was it the one, father? Then Abel said, yeah, that's it. And what's it doing here? Yeah. So when he said this, then the clock on the mantelpiece strikes 6 o'clock and everyone looks at it. And this man, Mr. Slater, brought the clock from Mr. Abel Meriwether's room. Not only the bureau, but also the beautiful or the handsome clock she brought from her father's room, and she kept the clock on the mantelpiece. Just then, The clock strikes 6 o'clock when everybody looks at it. Then Miss Abel Meriwether also looked at the clock and said, "Drat me, if that isn't my clock too, what the devil has been going on in this house?" Then Ben said, "Well, I will be hanged." Then Ben said, "We are caught." Then Mrs. Jordan, she rose and said, "I will tell you what has been going on in this house, father. Nothing short of robbery." Then Mrs. Jordan, she got up from the table and told her father, "I will tell you what has been going on in this house, father, but nothing short of robbery." Then Mrs. Slater said, "Be quiet, Elizabeth." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "I will not be quiet. Oh, I will call it double-faced." Then Henry said, no, Elizabeth." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "And you too, are you such a poor creature that you must do every dirty thing she tells you?" Then Mrs. Jordan rebukes or scolds Henry that you are such a great fool to do all the stupid things whatever your wife tells you to do. Then Abel rose from the thumping the table and said, "Damn it all, will someone tell me what has been going on?" Then Mr. Abel Meriwether did not understand what has been going on in his house. Then Mrs. Jordan said, "Yes, I will. I will not see you robbed." Then Abel said, "Who has been robbing me?" Then Mrs. Jordan said, "Emilia and Henry are robbing you. They have stolen your clock and bureau." Then she said, "They sneaked into your room like thieves in the night and stole them after you were dead." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "Emilia and Henry have stolen your things, father. So they have stolen your clock and bureau. So they thought that you are dead and they enter your room in the night like thieves and stole your things like bureau and the clock." Then Henry and Mrs. Slater said, "Shh, quiet, Elizabeth." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "I will not be stopped. After you are dead, I say." When Mr. Henry and Mrs. Slater said, "Shh, be quiet, Elizabeth," then Mrs. Jordan said, "I will not be stopped because you thought that father was dead, and then thinking that father died and you stole the things." Then Abel said, "After who was dead?" Then Mrs. Jordan said, "You. They thought you were dead." Then Abel said, "But I am not dead, I am alive." Then Mrs. Jordan, "No, but they thought you were." Then Mrs. Jordan gave a clarity to her father, "No, father, but they thought you are dead." Here they refers to whom? Henry and Mrs. Slater. Henry and Mrs. Slater thought that you are dead. Just then, Abel gazes round at them. That means he looked at them. Because what was the situation according to the... So what was the scene there? They all wore black dress. Because all five of them thought Miss Abel Meriwether died. So now, according to the situation, they all wore a black dress. Then he understood why they are all in black dress. Then he said, "Oh, so that's why you are all in black today. You thought I was dead." Then he laughs and said, "That was a big mistake." And he sits and resumes his tea again. Then Mrs. Slater said, father. Now she is weeping. Here, sobbing means weep or cry. Then Mr. Slab said, "Father." Then Abel said, "It didn't take you long to start dividing my things between you. I will tell you what I am going to do. Since your mother died, I have lived part of the time with you, Emilia, and part with you, Lizzie. Well, I shall make a new will, leaving all my bits of things to whoever I am living with when I die. How does it strike you?" Now, Mr. Abel Meriwether died, said, "It did not take long time to divide my things between you, even though I am alive, but you started dividing my things between you. And since your mother died, I lived some time with you, Elizabeth, and some time with you, Emilia. And you thought a bit burden to take care of me. Now, well, I shall make a new will. Now I shall make a new will. Here will means what? A legal document. I shall make a new will, leaving all my bits of things, whoever I am living with when I die. So when I die, I leave all my things with whomever I am living with. How does it strike you?" Then Mrs. Jordan said, "You know, father, it's quite time you came to live with us again, and we would make you very comfortable." They said, "Father, it's quite time you came to live with us again, and now onwards, we will make you very comfortable." Then Mrs. Latter also said, No, he has not been with us as long as he was with you." So Mrs. Latter said, "Father was with you for a long time, but he did not stay with us for a long time, so you should be with us." Then Mrs. Jordan said, "I may be wrong, but I don't think father will fancy living with you after what has happened today." Mr. Jordan said, I may be wrong in thinking that father has died, but I don't think father will fancy living on with you after what has happened today." Then Abel said, "It seems to me that neither of you has any cause to feel proud about the way you have treated me." Then Abel said, "Neither of you has any cause to feel proud about the way you have treated me." That means you are not supposed to feel proud to keep me well, because you did not take care of me. So you did not to feel proud about it. Then Mr. Slater said, "If I have done anything wrong, I am sure I am sorry for it." Then Mr. Jordan also said the same thing and said, "I can't say more than that too." Then Abel said, "It's a bit too late to say it now. Neither of you care to put up with me." Now, then Mr. Abel Meriwether said, "It is a bit late to say sorry, because neither of you care to put up with me. Here, neither of you bother to take care of me." Then Mr. Slater and Mrs. Jordan said, No, father." Then Abel said, "Hey, you both say that because of what I have told you about leaving my money. Well, since you don't want me, I will go to someone that does." Now, Mr. Abel Meriwether understand the attitude or mentality of his two daughters. They do not want to take care of their father, but they are after his money. Then Ben said, "Come, Mr. Meriwether, You have got to live with one of your daughters. Then the son-in-law, Ben, said, "Come, Mr. Meriwether, you got right to live with one of your daughters." Then Abel said, "I will tell you what I have got to do. On Monday next, I have got to do three things. I have got to go to the lawyer and alter my will. And I have got to go to the insurance office and pay my premium. And I have got to go to St. Philip Church and get married." When Mr. Abel Meriwether said that he is going to do three important things, here, what are the three important things? So now let us see the words of Mr. Abel Meriwether. "Well, I will tell you what I have got to do. On next Monday, I have got to do three things. Okay, what are three things? First one, I have to go to the lawyer and alter my will. So first thing, I will go to the lawyer and change my will. I will change my legal document. And second thing, I have to go to the insurance office and pay my premium. So the second important thing, I have to go to the insurance office and pay my premium. And third one, I have to go to St. Philip Church and get married. So these are the three important things I have to do." Then Ben and Henry said, "What?" When Mr. Abel Meriwether said that he is going to get married, then they were all shocked and confused and said, "What?" Then Mr. John said, "Got married?" "Get married?" Then Mrs. Slater said, "He is out of his sense." Then when Mr. Abel Meriwether told that he is going to get married at the age of nearly 70, then Mrs. Slater told that he is out of his sense. Here we can see a beautiful inn. Inn means a hotel. And this, so the name of the inn is Ringo Bells. Ringo Bells. Then Abel said, "I say, I am going to get married." And Mrs. Slater said, "Who to?" And Mr. Abel said, "To Mr. John Shawrooks, who keeps the Ringo Bells. We have had it fixed up a good while now, but I was keeping it for a pleasant surprise." Then he rises from the chair and said, "I felt I was a bit of a burden to you, so I found someone who would think it a pleasure to look after me, and who shall be very glad to see you at the ceremony." Then he gets to the door and said, "Till Monday, then 12 o'clock at St. Philip Church." Then opened the door and said, "It's a good thing you brought that bureau downstairs, Emilia. It will be handier to carry it across to the Ringo Bells on Monday." Then he goes on. Here, Miss Abel Meriwether, when Mr. Slater asked then he said, "Mr. John Shawrooks is going to get married. And who is the owner of the hotel Ringo Bells? We have had it fixed up a good while now, but I was keeping it for a pleasant surprise. Then I felt it was a bit of a burden to you, so I found someone who would think it a pleasure to look after me. Then who shall be very glad to see you at the ceremony." Here, what is the ceremony? The marriage ceremony with Mr. John Shawrooks at St. Philip's Church. Then he told Mr. Slater, "It's a good thing you brought that bureau down, Emilia. It will be had he had to carry it across to ring of bells on Monday. It will be easier for me to carry the bureau across the ring of bells on Monday. Then the curtain falls. So this is the beautiful play written by William Stanley Upton, the English playwright. Now let us see the glossary or the important words in this play. Gingerly. Gingerly means in a careful way. Next, poke. Poke means to push. And what the devil? Old-fashioned way of showing annoyance or displeasure. And this phrase is always used in questions. Tomfoolery. Foolish or silly behavior. What the dickens? It's an idiom. It's used in questions instead of devil to show that you are annoyed or surprised. And vindicative whisper. Talking about someone in a harsh, hasty manner. Then, what the devil? It's used in question to show that you are annoyed or surprised. Double-faced, hypocritical, deceitful, dishonest. Thumping, hitting hard, will. Legal document that says what is to happen to somebody's property after his or her death. Fancy, want or feel like. Consternation, unemotional and skinful. Ring of bells, the name of a restaurant. Handier, easier. Now let's see the home tax. You know that in the lesson, the dear departed, Mr. Abel Meriwether decided to abandon his two daughters, Emilia and Elizabeth, and wanted to marry Mrs. John Shawrooks, who kept a restaurant. Now the question is, now write a possible conversation among his daughters, sons-in-law, and his granddaughter Victoria.